In this video, we are going to see the topic two port network. Okay, so what does two port network means? So first you should know port. What does mean by port? You should know. So the port is nothing but a pair of terminal at which an electrical signal or electrical energy enters or leaves a network is called a port. Okay, so we will take it as a, you just consider this is one linear network. Okay, so for this linear network, so we may give some input voltage, we may take some output voltage from some terminals. Okay, so such a terminal we are calling it as a port. Okay, so a port is nothing but a pair of terminal through which an electrical signal can enter or leave a network. It is called as a port. Okay, so there are different types of network is there. Okay, so that is a one port network, two port network, multi port networks are there. Okay, so what does mean by one port network means if a network is having only one pair of such a terminal. Okay, that is the network is having only one port. Port means a pair of terminal. Okay, if the network is having one pair of terminal means that a network is called as a one port network. Okay, then two port network means if the network is having two pair of terminal. Okay, two pair of terminal means that network is called as a two port network. Okay, so in this two port network, so this is the basic block diagram of two port network. So in this two port network, the terminal, this pair of terminal we have to denote it as 1 1 dash, and the second terminal we have to denote it as 2 2 dash. Okay, and this 1 1 dash is the input terminal. Okay, through this input terminal only we are applying some voltage. So the input voltage applied to this two port network is you just consider as a V1. And the current flowing through, because of this input voltage, the current entering into this port 1, we have to note it as a I1. Okay, similarly, the voltage available at the port 2, 2 dash, you just consider as a V2. And the output current flowing through the port 2, 2 dashes, you have to take it as a I2. Okay, so this is the representation of two port network. Okay, so normally that is we are using in electrical, in electronic circuits and everything. So that a transistor, we are using transistor and so on. So many devices we are using. So the transistor research, it is a very good example of one two port network. Okay, so in the transistor, it is having the three terminals, base, emitter and collector. Okay, out of this three terminal, we are using the transistor in three different configuration, either common base configuration, common emitter configuration or common collector configuration. So what is mean by the name common? Out of that three terminal, that is one terminal is used as a common terminal for both input and output. Okay, for example, you take it as an example for common emitter configuration. So in this common emitter configuration, the emitter terminal is common for both input and output. Okay, and in that condition, in common emitter configuration, the input voltage is given in base. Okay, the input pair of terminal is base emitter. Okay, and we are taking output across the terminal, collector and emitter. So that the collector and emitter, it is a output port, right? So the base emitter is a input port 1 1 dash, and collector emitter is a output port 2 2 dash. So the transistor is a very good example of the two port network. Okay, and some examples for the two port networks are transformers, transmission lines, amplifiers, filter, electronic circuits. So all these things, it is said to be the two port network. Okay, so the transistor is a very good example of two port device. Okay, two port device. So if the network is having only one pair of terminal means it is called as a one port device. If the network is having two such a pair of terminal means it is called as a two port device. Okay, and the next one, if some network is having more than two ports, okay, three ports, four ports, five ports, etc. Okay, so the microwave components are having multi-port. Okay, multi-port, that is circulator. These are all the multi-port network. Okay, so that elements we are calling it as a multi-port network. Okay, so in this unit we are going to see the analysis of the two-port network. Okay, two-port network. So by in order to so in this thing, so you should know the name of the ports. This 1 1 dash is called as input port. Okay, so that is here in this input port only we are going to apply the energy source. So that is input. We are going to apply the input voltage across this input port. So we are going to take the output from the output port. Okay, so that's why this is said to be the output port. This is said to be the input port. Okay, and the next one. So in order to analyze this two port network, so we are using different parameter methods we are using. Okay, so what are the parameters we are using in order to analyze the two port network? Means, so Z parameter, Y parameter, H parameter, and ABCD parameters. Okay, and the inverse ABCD parameter is also there. Okay, but in our syllabus we are having these four parameters. Okay, so the first one is Z parameter. So what is that? You know the name, you know the term is Z. Okay, so in electrical circuit, Z is nothing but a impedance. Okay, so the Z parameter, it is otherwise called as impedance parameter. Okay, and this Z parameter, while calculating the Z parameter, we are making either input port open circuited or output port is open circuited. So that's why the Z parameters are called as open circuit impedance parameters. Okay, then the second parameter, it is said to be the Y parameter. Okay, so Y means, you know what is Y? Y is said to be the admittance. It's a reciprocal of impedance. Okay, it's an admittance. So the Y parameter, it is also called as an admittance parameter. Okay, so while calculating this Y parameter, so we have to make either the input port and output port, we have to make either short circuited. So that's why this Y parameter, the other name of Y parameter is a short circuited admittance parameter. Okay, and the third one is a H parameter. So H means hybrid parameter. Okay, hybrid parameter. So this hybrid parameter, it is used to analyze the transistor based circuits. Correct? And the fourth one is a ABCD parameter. So the ABCD parameter, or the other name of the ABCD parameter is transmission parameter. So this transmission parameter, it is used to analyze, used to perform the analysis for a transmission lines. Okay, so these are only four different parameters we are going to use in order to analyze the two port network. Okay, so what is the basic thing behind this parameter means? So in this two port network, there are four variables are there. Okay, so what are the variables used in this two port network? Input voltage, input current, output voltage, output current. Okay, so out of this four variable, in each parameter method, we are going to use two variable as a independent variable, the another two variable as a dependent variable. Okay, so we are going to write the two equation in terms of the other two variables. Okay, it is said to be the basic thing behind this Z parameter. Okay, so we will see one by one. Okay, the first one, impedance parameter or Z parameter. Okay, so impedance parameter or Z parameter we are going to discuss. So from the name itself, so we are going to write the two equation. Okay, so but here in this impedance parameter, the current, input current and output current, okay, both the currents are taken as independent variable, and input voltage and output voltage are dependent variable. Okay, so we are going to write input voltage and output voltage in terms of input current and output current. Means that two equation, we are calling it as a Z parameter equation. Okay, so sometimes they ask write down the Z parameter equation. It is a 1-2 mark question. Means we have to write these two equations. Okay, so what is Z parameter equation? The input voltage V1, it can be written as Z11 into I1 plus Z12 into I2. Okay, the second equation, output voltage V2, can be written as Z21 into I1 plus Z22 into I2. So these two equations are calling it as a Z parameter equation. So in this equation, so you know V1 is the input voltage, V2 is the output voltage, I1 is the input current, I2 is the output current. Okay, so beyond this, so we are having the four values. Z11, Z12, Z21 and Z22. So what is this Z11? Z means simply impedance. Okay, so the suffix we are using 11, 12, 21, 22. Okay, so these four values we are calling it as a Z parameter constants. Okay, so now we are going to derive the value of this Z parameter constants. So first one, so we are going to use the two steps. Okay, so first step, if we want to find from the first equation, if we want to find the Z11, means we have to make the second term as zero. Okay, so how to make the second term zero? we have here the Z12 is a constant, so we can't make Z12 as a zero. Okay, so we have to make I2 as zero. Okay, what is I2? The I2 is nothing but a current flowing in the second port. Okay, but how to make the output port, that is how to make this current I2 equal to zero? In which condition the current flowing in a particular thing is zero? So we know that the output port is open circuited condition. Okay, but if this port is not closed, means there is no current flowing in the second port. Okay, that is the thing. But in order to find out the value of this Z11 and Z21 value, so we have to make this I2 equal to zero. So the first one, I am putting I2 equal to zero. That is, I am making the second port is, the second port is, it is a short open circuited. Okay, so by making the output port is open circuited, so if I substitute this I2 equal to zero in equation number one, but in equation number one the second term is zero, so we get V1 equal to Z11 into I1. From this our aim is to find out the value of Z11, but from this Z11 equal to V1 divided by I1 under the condition of I2 equal to zero. So this is the value of Z11. But from this equation, you see what is Z11? The Z11 is said to be, it's a ratio of input voltage divided by input current. That is input voltage divided by input current under the condition of output port is open circuited. Okay. So input voltage divided by input current means, what is input voltage divided by input current? This ratio, we are calling it as an input impedance. So the Z11, we are calling it as a open circuit input impedance or driving point input impedance. Okay, so similarly, substituting I2 equal to zero in equation number two. Okay, so in equation number two, if you are substituting I2 equal to zero, the second term, it becomes zero. So V2 equal to Z21 into I1. So from this Z21 can be written as V2 by I1. So what is the ratio output voltage divided by input current? Output voltage divided by voltage by current means it is a impedance. So here output voltage divided by input current. So this is said to be the forward transfer impedance. So the word, the name Z21 is said to be, this first two is in the numerator. The second one, the subscript, is said to be the denominator. So the Z21 is said to be the forward transfer impedance. Okay. And so we calculated the two value Z11 and Z21. So next one, we are going to calculate Z12 and Z22. So in order to calculate these two values, we have to make I1 as zero. Okay. So next step, we are going to substitute the I1 equal to zero. Okay. So the step number two is putting I1 equal to zero. That is, we are making the input port is open circuited. So if you are making input port is open circuited, the equation number one can be written as V1 equal to, the first term gets zero. So V1 equal to Z12 into I2. You see, V1 equal to Z12 into I2. So from this Z12 can be written as V1 divided by I2. So by here, it's a ratio of input voltage divided by output current. So this input voltage divided by output current. So this is called as the reverse transfer impedance. Okay. Then the next one is putting I1 equal to zero. Similarly, in fourth equation, second equation, we will get V2 equal to Z22 into I2. But from this, Z22 can be written as V2 by I2. What is V2? Output voltage. What is I2? Output current. So the, it's a ratio of output voltage divided by output current. So output voltage divided by output current is said to be the output impedance. Okay, so we derived the four values. Okay, you see, just see. What is Z11? It is an input impedance. Okay. That is impedance looking at the input port. What is Z22? It is the impedance at the output side. Okay. So impedance looking at the output side. So this is the output impedance. And what is Z12? It is a reverse transfer impedance. And what is Z21? It is a forward transfer impedance. So both these four values are the unit for the above four values are the ohms, correct? Ohms and values are ohms. And if this two port network, it is a if the two port network, it is a symmetrical network means, okay, so if it is a bilateral network means the value of Z12 and Z21 it remains same. Okay, that is the reciprocal network or bilateral network means if the value of Z12, Z21 are same means that a network is called as the reciprocal network. Okay, similarly, if the value of Z11 and Z22, input impedance and output impedance both are same means that particular network can be a symmetrical network. Okay, so these are all the things behind Z parameter. Okay, so the next thing we are going to see the problem related to this Z parameter. Okay, so the first problem you see, find the Z parameter for the network shown in figure below. Okay, so this is a one circuit. So for this network, we have to find out the Z parameters. Okay, you see, so this is the two port network. This is the port 11 dash. This is the port 22 dash. Okay, and the first one we have to mark the four variables. So this is the input voltage V1. This is the input current I1, and voltage across the output port is V2. Current flowing through this output port is a I2. Okay, you just mark it. Okay, so first one we have to write down the Z parameter equation. So we know that V1 equal to Z11 I1 plus Z12 into I2. V2 equal to Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. Okay, so how to calculate Z11, Z12, Z21 and Z22? So first step is to, we have to make the output current zero. Okay, same procedure. So if output port I2 equal to 0, if you are making I2 equal to 0, the port 2 is open circuited. So this diagram, it can be changed as the output port is open circuited. If this output port is open circuited, means this 15 ohm resistor is not connected to our network. Correct? So this is the diagram. So we are getting only this one loop. Okay, so this output port is open circuited. That's why there is no current flowing through this 15 ohm resistor. So this is just disconnected. Okay, but from this one, you just apply KVL to this loop. But if you are applying KVL to this loop, means V1. Okay, so V1 can be written as, so how to write the KVL equation? The voltage V1 can be written as 10 into I1 plus 5 into I1. Okay, you just see 10 into I1 plus 5 into I1. So from this, so if you're adding these two things, 15 I1. So V1 equal to 15 I1. So from this, the ratio V1 divided by I1, it is called as the Z11. So this is the input impedance. Okay. So similarly, so we have to find one more parameter, Z21. So what is Z21? It's a ratio of V2 divided by I1. So we have to make the relation between output voltage and input current. So you see the diagram. So in this diagram, what is output voltage? Okay, this is the one. The voltage across this port, it is said to be the V2. Okay, in this V2, so here there is no current is flowing through the 15 ohm resistor. So it is just short-circuited manner. What is the voltage across this port? It is nothing but a voltage across this 5 ohm resistor. Okay, so what is the voltage across the 5 ohm resistor? 5 into I1. So the voltage V2, it can be written as 5 into I1. So from this, the ratio V2 divided by I1, it can be written as Z21. So the value of Z21 equal to 5 ohms. Okay, so the two parameter calculated. Okay, calculated by the method of port 2 is open circuited. Okay, similarly, in order to find out the remaining two parameter, that is Z12 and Z22, we have to make this I1 as 0. Okay, append the diagram. In the given diagram, we have to make I1 as 0. If you are making I1 as 0, means that is input port is open circuited. So there is no current flowing in the input loop. Okay, only the current is flowing in the output loop. So there is no current flowing in the 10 ohm resistor. What about the diagram? You see, so the diagram is like this. Okay, there is no current flowing in the 10 ohm resistor. So there is a current I2 is flowing in this loop only. Okay, from this one, you just apply KVL equation for this output loop. So if you are applying KVL equation for this output loop, the voltage V2, it can be written as the voltage V2 equal to I2 into 15. Right? So apply KVL like this. Since current is flowing in this direction, so V2 equal to 15 into I2 plus 5 into I2. So V2 equal to 15 into I2 plus 5 into I2. So from this, V2 equal to 20 into I2. So the ratio V2 divided by I2, it is called as 20 ohms. So this is the value of Z22. Okay, Z22. So similarly, Similarly, we have to find out the value of Z12. So Z12 means, you know, it's a ratio of V1 by I2. So we have to find the relation between V1 and I2. Okay. But from the circuit V1, okay, the current flowing through this 10 ohm resistor is zero. So it is just a short circuited 10 ohm illada madha. So and at that case, you just find the voltage across this 1-1 dash. What is the voltage across the 1-1 dash? It is nothing but a voltage across the 5 ohm resistor only. Okay. So the voltage V1 can be written as 5 into I2. Okay. From this V1 divided by I2, it can be written as 5 ohm. Okay. So we calculated the four values. So Z11 is 15 ohms, Z12 is 5 ohm, Z21 is 5 ohm, and Z22 is 20 ohm. Okay, so that's why the Z parameter matrix, it can be written as the Z parameter matrix, it is equal to, it is a 2 by 2 matrix. Z11, Z12, Z21, and Z22. So which can be written as 15, 5, 5, 20. Okay, so you see these values. So out of this four value, this Z12, Z21 values are same. You see? Okay, 5, 5. About this two-port network, it may be a reciprocal network. Okay, if the Z11, Z12 and Z22, Z12 and Z21 values are same, means that a network, it can be call it as a reciprocal network. Okay, so this is the problem. Okay, this is the one type of problem in Z parameter. Okay, then the second problem. So you just see, find the Z parameter of the circuit shown in figure. Okay, so this is the May 2018 question. Okay, you see, this is the diagram. This is the circuit given. So by in this thing, we are going to find the values of Z parameters. Okay, Z parameter. So by in this thing, so first one, so you just mark the currents first. Okay. So first one, this is the input port. So voltage applied at the input port is V1. So current entering in the input port is I1. Similarly, voltage applied at the second port is V2. And the current flowing in the second port is I2. Okay. And you just see here one dependent source is there. Okay. So what is the value of this dependent source? 3 into I1. Okay. This value is 3 into I1. Okay, 3 into I1. So in this diagram, there are three loops are there. So you just see current flowing in this loop is I1. Current flowing in this loop is I2. So in center, we are having one more loop. Okay. So you just take the current flowing in the center loop, you just take it as a I3. Okay, I3. But from this, so the current flowing in this loop is I3. Current flowing in this loop is I2. But what is the value of this dependent current source? About this dependent current source, the current flowing through this branch is nothing but I3 is flowing like this, I2 is flowing like this. So I3, I2 added, that added current is flowing as a 3 into I1. So we can write it as the current source 3 into I1 can be written as I2 plus I3. Okay. But from this, you just find out the value of I3. So I3 equal to 3 into, so just you rearrange. So I3 you keep in left side. So I3 can be written as 3 into I1 minus I2. So you take it as a equation number 1. Okay. And so you just apply KVL equation for loop 1. Okay. If you are applying KVL equation for loop 1, so the voltage V1 equal to 1 into the current flowing through this 1 ohm resistor. What is the current? This 1 ohm resistor is common for loop 1 and loop 3. Okay. So I1 is flowing this direction, I3 is flowing from bottom to top. So the two currents are flowing in opposite direction. What is the voltage across this 1 ohm resistor? 1 into I1 minus I3. So the voltage V1 can be written as 1 into I1 minus I3. Okay. So already you know the value of I3 in terms of I1 and I2. Okay. So substitute the I3 value in this equation. So we will get V1 equal to I1 minus 3I1 minus I2. So if you are simplifying, means we will get minus 2 into I1 plus I2. Okay. So we derived the first Z parameter equation. Okay. The voltage V1, it can be written as Z11 into I1 plus Z12 into I2. Okay. This is the one Z parameter equation. So similarly, so the next one we have to apply KVL for the super mesh circuit. Okay, so we can't write the ordinary KVL equation for the second loop and third loop, since the current, okay, one current source is available in between the loop one and loop two. Okay, already we studied in first unit. Okay, so if the common one common current source is available between the two loops, means we can't write the separate KVL equation. We have to use the super mesh equation. Okay, what is super mesh equation? You just remove this current source, and we have to combinely the second loop and third loop, we have to, for these two loops, we have to write combinely one KVL equation. It is called as a super mesh equation. Correct? Up the super mesh equation. So how can you write the super mesh equation? You just see. So the voltage V2. Okay, you see line this direction. So the voltage V2 equal to this resistance 2 ohm into, what is the current flowing in this resistor? It's a I3. Right? So current flowing is I3. So we can written as, so 2 into I3 plus V2 A plus 1 into I3 minus I1 equal to 0. Okay. Up in this equation, I1 is there, V2 is there, I3 is there. But we want V2 equation in terms of I1 and I2 only. Okay. We have to remove this I3. So already we are having the I3 value in terms of I1 and I2. So you just substitute this I3 value in this equation. So you just rearrange. So after rearranging, we will get the V2 equation as minus 8 into I1 plus 3 into I2. Okay. Aba, you see the equation number 2. So this equation number 2 is resemblance to the second Z parameter equation. This equation number 1 is similar to the first Z parameter equation. So the equation number 1 and 3, it is called as, so the equation number 2 and 3, you just compare it with our standard Z parameter equation. So this is the standard Z parameter equation. V1 equal to Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2. V2 equal to Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. But if you are comparing this, you see the equation number 2, you just compare it with this equation. What is the value of Z11? It is minus 2. What is the value of Z12? It is 1. Okay, similarly, you compare the third equation with this V2, we get Z21 equal to minus 8, Z22 equal to 3. Okay, from this, the two port Z parameter, you have to write it as minus 2, 1, minus 8, 3. Okay, so this is another method of solving the Z parameter solution. Okay, so in first problem, we are using one different method, that is, we are calculating, that is, we are making first output port is zero. So if you are making output port zero, so we are find outing the Z11 as V1 by I1. Okay. And Z21 is calculated. Next step, I1, we are making I1 zero, and we have to calculate the two things. Okay. It is the one method. The another method of solving this Z parameter method is that we have to write for the given circuit diagram. For the given circuit, we have to make two equation in the structure. So, okay. So, in a structure, the input voltage can be written as, a function of I1 and I2. Similarly, output voltage can be written as a function of I1 and I2. Okay. So, we have to write two equation. We have to obtain two equation in the structure, and you compare the equation with this one, we will get the answer. Okay, this is the another method. Okay, this is the another method of solving this problem. Okay, so I solved the first problem in the second method. Okay, the same, the first problem you discussed, you know, in a different method, that problem we are solving in the second method. Okay, you see, find the Z parameter for the network shown in figure. Okay, the same circuit in method 2 I am solving. But in method 2, so don't make output port 0, input port 0, okay, no need. So in that case, you just see, so this is the input port current, this is the output port current. But what is the current flowing through this 5 ohm resistor means? So that current I1 plus I2 is flowing through this port. Okay, but you just apply KVL equation to input loop. If you are applying KVL equation to this input loop, so we can written as V1 equal to 10 into I1 plus 5 into I1 plus I2. Okay, you just collect the term. So V1 equal to 15 I1 plus 5 into I2. So we got the equation, we got the first Z parameter equation V1 in terms of I1 and I2. Okay. Similarly, we have to write the KVL equation for the second loop. So what is the KVL equation for second loop? V2 equal to 15 into I2 plus 5 into I1 plus I2. Okay, if you are rearranging, we get V2 equal to 5 into I1 plus 20 into I2. This is the second equation. So you see these two equations, are in Z parameter equation structure. Okay, this is the standard Z parameter equation structure. So we just compare this V1 equation with this V1 equation. So which one is a Z11? The Z11 is said to be the 15 and Z12 is a 5. Okay. Z21 is a 5, Z22 is a 20. So we got the same answer. Okay. So we can use any method, method 1 or method 2. Okay. So the method 2, I think the method 2 is a easiest method. Okay. When compared to the method 1, the method 2 is a easiest method. Okay. Just for the total circuit, we have to write two equation. Okay. Input voltage in terms of input current and output current. Output voltage in terms of input current and output current. Okay, we have to write two equation in this structure. Now we will get the directly we will get the answers. Okay, the same answer we will get. Okay, so this is the Z parameter methods. Okay, so in any method, in method one, we can solve any problem in method one and method two. Okay, so which method is easy for you, you can solve it. Okay, so thank you.